Hey everyone, Jack Joss is here, CEO at Ramblin' Jackson and TNLA Academics Instructor. Right now I'm at the 2021 Nursery Landscape Expo in San Antonio, and I'm excited to interview one of the speakers today, Tom Shea. Tom, what did you present at the conference today?
The topic was called Disrupting or Prompting. Does this affect how you approach business?
And what, tell me more about that. What are some of the problems that you're seeing in the green industry that your talk helps people through?
Well, most of us in the green industry are going to say, wow, business is great. Awesome. We're so happy. Business is going crazy. And I go, and what part of that did you have anything to do with? And for most of us, it's no, I'm just along for the ride. You didn't make this business growth come to you. And one of my points is saying, your business may be great. You didn't cause it. And very likely, there's nothing that says you're making any more money out of it. You just got a whole lot more business out there. And when the pandemic goes away, then my next question is your business going to continue to grow, or was this just like a ride at Disney World? It came, it went, and it's over. We're done. So I'm saying, no, look, let's look at some things that we could do differently in the way we operate our business so it would continue to grow. What else could you be doing related to the industry? So if I'm a landscaper, you know, are we looking at hardscaping? Are we looking at doing lighting? Are we doing irrigation? Are we doing ponds? Mm-hmm. What else? And you say, oh, no, this is what I do. And I go, but there's an opportunity. And when a customer of yours is a landscaper says, hey, who could I get to put a pond in for me? That's a customer who just said to you, I know you don't do this, but if you did, I'd hire you. And probably the person you're going to tell them to go to is not going to pay you a finder's fee. So why are you letting this all go away? Why aren't you looking at, say, expanding the business? And so I gave a lot of examples this morning of businesses that have seen a situation and going, I can expand, I can add more to it. And say, well, I can't keep up with the business I got now. I understand, but you got to think farther ahead than just today.
So what's the line of saying, yeah, I can do that, and you're learning and expanding, and then sometimes you totally blow it, and the pond leaks, and it cracks, and all the plants fall in. Right? How do you in business when you're growing and you're trying to expand and there's a certain comfort zone, right, that people get stuck in and you gotta get out of it? How do you do that without compromising the quality and your reputation?
Well, you look and say, all right, how did you get into the landscape business? Was it because you went to a college and got a degree in horticulture? It was that it? Not to say let's take another however many years and go back and get another degree, but let's look at, where did I learn more about landscaping? Who taught me? What courses did I take? For example, are you a customer of, say, Site One or Bellegarde? Do they have schools? Are you attending their events and learning and saying, I could add this feature? Irrigation, you know, if a pond scares you, all right, let's go look at irrigation. Let's go look at lighting. Something that we could add. I mean, I'm not going to say all of a sudden, let's go into pool building. Okay, now that's a whole lot of another mess. But it's like there's business to be had. And my concern is for people who are just in the passenger seat right now, not in the driver's seat of their business.
And a lot of that has to do with mindset about having a business and choosing to be a business leader, right? Because we were talking earlier, many people kind of just happen to own a business.
Well, that's it. I was fortunate in my family. I'm fourth generation in my family. And my predecessors were teachers of, let's own a business. Now, if I were to sit down, you don't have the time for me to detail what all businesses, what did we sell? It's just about, we've sold about everything there is under the sun, because I'm a lover of being a business owner, not I'm a lover of plants. So I tell people in our setting today, we both love green. Unfortunately, some of us love green plants more than we like green money.
And so Tom, you were joking with me before the interview that you actually don't want to work with people one-on-one, do you?
I'm not a consultant. No, not it's not my thing. I love teaching and exposing people. But the sad part is people who usually call me have got a problem with their business they're wanting to solve. And with all of us, not just people I meet, but with all of us, generally the problem with the business is us as an owner.
And so what are some resources that you have for people who they can't work directly with you, but you can still help them? So tell us a little bit, how can we learn more online about you?
Well, we have created over the years, we have the largest website that's built for small business. There's nothing for sale on. I refuse to do that. Everything's for free. I like making decisions in business based upon fact and good numbers. So just about every question I've ever been asked about a business, so how should I make this decision? I've taken note of that question, sat down and figured out, hey, here's a formula that would answer this question, like, how do I get a better return on my investment, which is our topic this afternoon. So I know the numbers that goes into play. I build an Excel chart that here's what I need numbers, and I've got this information stud guy in Florida who somehow magically takes what I can draw on paper or put on an Excel chart and makes it into a calculator that shows up on our website. So you could go to our website, profitsplus.org, and say, show me the return on investment calculator. You go look at it, and it says, these are the numbers you need to punch in here. We don't use Google Analytics. We don't track anything. You punch in your numbers and go, that's my ROI right now. Okay, well, now that you see it, go take a number and change it. Any of the numbers that you can control, change it. Okay, well, what did that do for your ROI? Did it make it better or worse? Okay, well, if making this number smaller made your ROI bigger, then that's a number in our business. I need to focus on making it smaller.
Yeah, I love that. So check out the ROI calculator at profitplus.org.
Profits, P-R-O-F-I-T-S.
Profits.
Yeah, more than one.
Okay, profitsplus.org. Thank you. And Tom, thank you for coming on the show. My name is Jack Jostis, and I hope you enjoyed this video. See more of these interviews on the TNLA website and YouTube channel. My name is Jack Jostis, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.